the statue would probably be me sort of enjoying legal cannabis and watching television, if we're being honest. Hi, I'm Justin Simien. I am the creator of Dear White People, and welcome to my dictatorship. So I'd probably call it, I'd probably go for something really pretentious, like, humanity, or humanityville, or humanityland. These are all really terrible names for the country. You know what? Let's just go with Beyonce. Let's just call the country Beyonce. Let's keep it real. That's the best thing to call it. It would be called the Black House, my castle. And it would be some kind of Wakanda type situation. Like, I feel like there's an anti-grav. I feel like we're floating just above a lake. The statue would probably be me sort of enjoying legal cannabis and watching television, if we're being honest. The most important thing about running a country would be education. The teachers would be the highest paid people in the land. Democracy lives and dies by how educated the populace is. Not only educated in facts and histories, but educated in different ways of thinking. The reason why Black folks have so much imposter syndrome is because we're taught to think in a way that denies so much of our history. So everything would be about education. I think the national anthem should change every year because we're so stuck in these rules and ideas that really come from a time and place that doesn't actually reflect where we're at sometimes. We're so married to what we think the founding fathers were trying to say and be about that we actually sometimes don't evolve quite fast enough for the population. So I actually think maybe I'd have a contest or something. The album or the song that I'm most excited about each year would become the national anthem for the next year. National pastime would certainly be shade and certainly drag balls. Like the drag race finale would be the Super Bowl. And frankly, you're welcome. The minister of shade of Beyonce. God, I mean, Rue would be the obvious choice. You know, RuPaul really is the master and mistress of shade. Oh my God, a minister of shade. Ugh. I'm literally having a moment just absorbing what that would be. There would be no word for diversity in the Sovereign Nation of Beyonce because there wouldn't need to be. We'd all be mixed up together, honey. The whole idea of race and whiteness and purity, that would go away. There would be no race box on the census whatsoever. There would be no sort of policy around race. This idea of whiteness was created to sort of have an economic advantage in the abolition of slavery. Yes, cute vice piece, we're going there. And there would have been none of that in the Sovereign Nation of Beyonce. Obviously, in the Sovereign Nation of Beyonce, cannabis would be legal. Being Black and driving would also be legal. You'd be able to do that without being stopped or killed. Seems like a no-brainer to me, but we're struggling with that here. The right to bear arms would have to go. Sorry, if you want to hunt or something, child, we got virtual reality. As a Black gay dictator, I'm sure there's gonna be a few people in the Sovereign Nation of Beyonce that are gonna feel some type of way, but they're just gonna have to get used to it. I'm the dictator, sorry about it. You can move. You can go to America if you'd like to have guns. The military would be called the Rhythm Nation, of course. They would all be dressed like Janet and her background dancers in Rhythm Nation. We would solve problems through dance. Don't you think war would be so much better if it's really just about resolving our conflicts through dance? Like, if Beat It could be real. Ooh, girl, let's see North Korea and America go at it, child. They about to dance it out. That would be so fun. I grew up on Star Trek. I'm a big old nerd. I'm a blurred. So I feel like the National Science Project gotta be like, is the aliens out there? We got aliens? That would be the name of it. Is the aliens out there? We got aliens, ? After everything I've just described, drag race being the Super Bowl, dance offs instead of war, I don't really understand why you wouldn't wanna immigrate to the nation of Beyonce. I don't know. God, now I'm sad. I wanna live in the nation of Beyonce. I don't even need to be a dictator. I just wanna live there at this point.